Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will cover the set 45 of the Railway Special Current Affairs in English language. So let's start the video. And before this, there have been 44 parts that have been uploaded. If you are preparing for railways or any similar exams, then this series will be highly useful for you. The International Shooting Sports Federation, which is headquartered in Munich. Now Munich is a city in Germany, very famous for the Bayern Munich Football Club. So, International Shooting Sports Federation World Cup 2020 will be held in which country? It will take place in India. So, remember, India will actually host the ISSF World Cup 2020. Now, if they ask which country hosted the ISSF World Cup 2019, then the answer is Munich. Yes, the headquarter. Which country has become the 76th country to join the International Solar Alliance? 76th country to join ISA is Palau. P-A-L-A-U, Palau. This is the order that you must remember, and lot of times these questions are asked. So for example, recently in the FSSAI exam, which was on 24th of July, they asked about which two South American countries have recently joined ISA. And you can see Argentina and Bolivia as the answer, right? So 71st country was Japan, 72nd is Argentina, 73rd was Saudi Arabia, 74th Bolivia, 75th United Kingdom, and 76th is Palau. And the headquarter of International Solar Alliance is where? It is in Gurugram, Haryana. 44th session of the World Heritage Committee will be hosted by which country? Now, this is important. The city, first of all, you remember the city. It is called Fuzhou. F-U-Z-H-O-U, Fuzhou. It is in China. So China will host the World Heritage Committee meeting next year. And this year, in 43rd meeting, where was it hosted? Super important question, it was hosted by Baku. Baku is the capital of Azerbaijan, because this is the place where they declared Jaipur as a World Heritage City. Which of the following countries has laid the foundation stone of Baba Guru Nanak University? Baba Guru Nanak University, named after the first Guru, Sikh Guru, Baba Guru Nanak, will be set up in Nankana Sahib in Pakistan. Nankana Sahib in Pakistan. Also, Pakistan has recently allowed 5,000 pilgrims to attend, you know, to visit Kartarpur via the Kartarpur corridor from India visa-free. 5,000. And Pakistan has recently inaugurated Maharaja Ranjit Singh statue. Maharaja Ranjit Singh statue in Lahore Fort. Which of the following personalities has been selected for the Sangeet Natak Academy Fellow, that is Academy Ratan Award? There are four personalities. Three are given here. Zakir Hussain, the famous tabla player. Sonal Mansingh, dancer, classical dancer. Jatin Goswami, the answer is all of the above. And who is the fourth person? Fourth person is K.K. Pillai. K.K. Pillai. Which of the following shooters won the gold medal in the women's 10 meter air rifle event at the Junior World Cup, which was held in Suhl in Germany? So first of all, you should remember that the Junior World Cup in 2019 took place in Suhl in Germany. And in women's 10 meter event, it was Ella Vanil Valarivan. She won the gold medal. So here is the medal tally. India finished at number 1 position. This is very important. And China finished at 2nd. And you can see both India and China, they won 24 medals apiece. But India has more golds. That is why India leapfrogged China in the table. So India is number 1, China is number 2. And these are the players who have won the gold medals, although it is not important to remember the names of all. They will just ask probably the location, which is Suhl in Germany, and they will ask the position of India in the medal tally. Reebok, the famous fitness brand Reebok, it has appointed which person as the brand ambassador? So there are two people who have recently been appointed as the brand ambassador for Reebok. One is Varun Dhawan, the famous actor, and the second is Katrina Kaif. Katrina Kaif and Varun Dhawan. The Supreme Court of India has constituted a 3-member high-powered committee to urgently frame and implement an emergency response plan for the protection of which bird species? So there are two birds which are in danger. In fact, one which is called Great Indian Bustard, only 150 are remaining in India, and therefore it is critically endangered. It is also the state bird of Rajasthan. And the second one is the lesser florican. So the answer is A and B. Supreme Court has made a committee to protect these two birds. United States has celebrated which mission's 50th anniversary on 16th of July 2019. It was the Apollo 11 mission, which was responsible for the first ever landing on moon. Remember, Neil Armstrong was the first person to go on moon. He was an American and the mission was Apollo 11. America has recently started the death penalty once again. America had done away with the capital punishment, but now they have started giving death penalty once again. The Union government, they want to increase the production of coal in India. Okay, so they want to have more coal. The target is to have 100 crore ton or 1 billion ton of coal by which year? We should have it by 31st March 2023. So the answer is 2022-23. Now tell me, write down in comments, who is the coal minister of India? Okay, and what is the constituency? Let's see who answers this question. Which company has launched a mobile app called JEE Ready? JEE Ready. To foray into education sector in India. This company is now an edutech player. It is Amazon. Owned by Jeff Bezos. And don't forget, there is a project called Quipper of Amazon where they are providing broadband internet via satellites. So project Quipper is Amazon. Who has won the Arjuna Award recently? These awards were given by the Sports and Youth Affairs Minister Kiran Rijiju. Two players won the Arjuna Awards. One is Smriti Mandhana. She is a female cricket player from India. And the second one is Rohan Bopanna, who was a tennis player. Rohan Bopanna and Smriti Mandhana. Remember, recently there was a magazine that was released called Crick Zone. It is the first ever magazine in India dedicated to women's cricket. It was launched from Jaipur. And Smriti Mandhana was on the cover of Crick Zone. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has launched Jan Jagrukta Abhiyan in which city recently? Jan Jagrukta Abhiyan, as the name says, it is about the public awareness about three diseases: dengue, malaria and chikungunya. All the three are caused by the mosquito bite, malaria by the female Anopheles and dengue and chikungunya by Aedes aegypti mosquito. So it started in New Delhi to make the citizens aware about the three epidemics that India usually faces. The central government has reduced the interest rate on general provident fund for the quarter July to September by 10 basis points to what? So basically, what is the interest rate on general provident fund now? Earlier it was 8%, now it has been reduced by 10 basis points or 0.1 percentage points to 7.9%. So the answer is B. Andhra Bank has launched an artificial intelligence interactive assistant chatbot called what? Artificial intelligence is used for chatbots, robots, humanoid robots, interactive assistant or virtual assistant. They all mean the same thing. So trick to remember is AB, Andhra Bank. So it is called Abhi, A-B-H-I, Abhi. And these are some chatbots of different banks. So there is a iPal robot of ICICI Bank. HDFC has two. One is called EVA and the second one is IRA, ERA, EVA and ERA. Kotak Mahindra's chatbot is called Kea. State Bank of India's is called SIA. Canara Bank has two. One is called Mitra, second one is Candy. Yes Bank chatbot is Yes Tag, and Axis Bank robot is called Axis Aha. World Health Organization has declared Ebola outbreak in which country a global health emergency? This country was earlier called Zaire. It is the Democratic Republic of Congo. Capital is Kinshasa. Ebola is now a emergency. WHO is headquartered in Geneva and Tedros Adhanom is the Director General of WHO. Tedros Adhanom is from Ethiopia. WHO has recently declared Sri Lanka as measles free. Sri Lanka has been declared as measles free. Which woman weightlifter? She won 4 gold medals at the Open Asian Powerlifting Championship. Her name is Bhavna Tokekar. Bhavna Tokekar. The government of India has approved a project to build the India-based neutrino observatory in which district of Tamil Nadu? India-based neutrino observatory will be set up in Theni district. Why was Theni district in news? Because it has a tiger reserve called Satyamangalam Tiger Reserve, which was declared as the best tiger reserve of India recently on the occasion of the International Tigers Day on 29th of July. As per the recent report by the Botanical Survey of India, Which Indian state has the highest number of orchid species? Now, orchid is a very different type of plant species, and the maximum are found in Arunachal Pradesh. Similarly, just as Botanical Survey of India said that Arunachal has the maximum orchid species, similarly, the Geological Survey of India, they have said that 35% of all the graphite in India is found in Arunachal Pradesh. Name the Indian naval ship which will go on a 2-month long Sagar Maitri mission. The phase 2 has started. Which Indian ship will go to Sagar Maitri mission? It is INS Sagar Dhwani. INS Sagar Dhwani. What is India's GDP growth projection according to Asian Development Bank for the current financial year, which is financial year 2020, that will end on 31st of March 2020? According to ADB, our growth will be 7%. These are the 5 most important ones. So according to Economic Survey, according to IMF, and according to Asian Development Bank, our growth will be 7%. Okay, so it's easy to remember. IMF, Economic Survey, and ADB, 7%. World Bank is a little more generous, 7.5%. And Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, that is OECD, headquartered in Paris, according to it, it is 7.25%. Which campaign of the Tourism Ministry has won the Pacific Asia Travel Association Gold Award, the PATA Gold Award? It is called Find the Incredible You. Find the Incredible You. The Minister for Tourism and Culture is Prahlad Patel. The government has made a target. They will open how many Ayush Wellness Center in the present financial year 2020. Total 4,200 Ayush Wellness Centers will be opened in India in 1 year. And Ayush Minister is Shripad Yesso Nayak. His constituency is North Goa. Two new districts have been carved out called Tenkasi and Changalpet in which state? Recently, another one, Kallakurichi, was also carved out. These three new districts are from Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu. Tenkasi district has been carved out from Tirunelveli and Changalpet has been carved out from Kanchipuram. So, these three. Tamil Nadu now has 35 districts. 35. And recently, remember, Madhya Pradesh, there is a 52nd new district called Niwadi. And Arunachal, three new districts. Which one? Pakke Kesang, Leparada and Shiomi. Also in Telangana, there are two new districts which are Narayanpet and Mulugu. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, they approved which project? It is Dibang project. It is a multi-purpose project in Arunachal Pradesh. They are asking what is the capacity of this project. Capacity is 2880 megawatt, 2880 megawatt. Remember, the dam will be 278 meter and this dam will be the highest dam in India. Okay, this is super important. Arunachal Pradesh, Dibang multipurpose project, the dam height will be 278 meter, which is the highest in India. Who has become the 6th Indian to be inducted into the ICC Hall of Fame? Before him, 5 Indian cricketers have been inducted: Bishan Singh Bedi, Kapil Dev, Sunil Gavaskar, Anil Kumble and Rahul Dravid. He is the 6th, he is the master blaster Sachin Tendulkar. And Alan Donald, the famous South African fast bowler, was also inducted into the ICC Hall of Fame. Who has become India's 64th chess grandmaster? His name is Prithu Gupta. He is only 15 years old. And this is the sequence. So D. Gukesh and P. Inian, they are the 60th and 61st respectively. And you can see all the new grandmasters are in 2019. So it's been a great year for Indian chess. Swayams Mishra, 62nd, Girish Kaushik, 63rd, and Prithu Gupta, 64th. Which bank has launched a new digital platform called InstaBiz that is made for micro, small and medium enterprises and for self-employed customer? InstaBiz was started by ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank and Mr. Sandeep Bakshi, he is the managing director and CEO of ICICI Bank. Who has been appointed as India's next ambassador to Israel? Israel is a good friend of India. We are buying LRNT tank spike missile from Israel also. Barak 8 is another missile that both the countries are jointly manufacturing. His name is Sanjeev Kumar Shingla. And these are the ones which are most commonly asked in your exam. So we have Harshvardhan Shingla, which is India's ambassador to America. Ajay Bisaria to Pakistan, and Pakistan's ambassador to India is Moinul Haq. Moinul Haq. In Sri Lanka, our ambassador is Taranjit Singh Sandhu, Nepal Manjeev Singh Puri, Bhutan Ruchira Kamboj, and China Vikram Mishri. Who among the following has been appointed as a private secretary to Prime Minister Modi? He is Vivek Kumar. Vivek Kumar. There is a book that has been launched recently on Kargil War. Recently, we completed 20 years of Kargil War on 26th of July. So, 26th of July is the Kargil Victory Day. The book is called Kargil Untold Stories from the War. This book is written by Rachna Bisht Rawat. Which Indian sportsperson has been nominated for the International Association of Athletics Federation Veteran Pin, which is kind of a lifetime achievement award? So IAAF, first of all, it is headquartered in Monaco, and she is PT Usha. Remember, PT Usha was called Paioli Express, P-A-Y-Y-O-L-I, Paioli Express. Can you tell me in which district of Kerala will you find this place called Paioli? Write down in comments. And there is one called Hima Das, who is called the Dhing Express. She is from Assam. The Union Minister of Human Resource Development, Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, his constituency is Haridwar. He has released a University Grants Commission guide to student induction program. What is the name of this student induction program guide? It is called Diksharam, which means beginning of education. So basically, whenever a student goes to new college or university, this guide will help him to acclimatize and adapt to the new surroundings. Which country has recently started rhino impact bonds? It was started by London Zoological Society recently for the conservation of black rhino. It is a two-horned rhino which is now critically endangered. The fifth edition of the International Police Expo was organized in which city? International Police Expo took place in New Delhi. And remember, the best police station of India is the Kalu Police Station in Bikaner district of Rajasthan. The second best is the Campbell Bay in Andaman Nicobar. And the third best is Farakka Police Station in Murshidabad district of West Bengal. You should also know about some IITs and their recent achievements. IIT Delhi, they have made India's first laptop, which is in Braille for the visually impaired or the blind. It is called Dotbook. IIT Hyderabad has done three things. First of all, they have started a BTech course in artificial intelligence. It is India's first IIT to start a dedicated course in BTech for AI. And India's first Center of Excellence for Drone Development will be set up in IIT Hyderabad. And they have also developed a smartphone-based system to detect the adulteration in milk. IIT Ropad in Punjab, it has developed a mobile app called Roshni that will help the blind people to recognize currency notes. IIT Banaras Hindu University, recently, supercomputer called Param Shivai was inaugurated here by PM Modi. IIT Madras, very recently, it has made a drone-based device called Agricopter, which will help the farmers in spraying of insecticide and pesticide. So IIT Madras has done a lot of things. So for example, it has made a machine called Nero, which can make water from air. India's first cold spray smart laboratory has been opened in IIT Madras. IIT Madras is also the number one IIT in India according to the NIRF ranking of the Ministry of HRD, National Institutional Ranking Framework. IIT Madras has also developed a portable solar-powered cold storage device, and it has developed a method to read the Bharati script using OCR, that is optical character recognition. They have also developed a microprocessor or a chip called Shakti. IIT Bombay has also developed a microprocessor or a chip called Ajit. So don't get confused between Ajit and Shakti. Ajit is by IIT Mumbai and Shakti is by IIT Madras. IIT Kharagpur, which is in West Bengal, it has signed a memorandum of understanding for setting up of Center for Inland and Coastal Maritime Technology. Who has been appointed as the chairperson of the Inland Waterways Authority of India? So there were five inland waterways in India earlier on. The most important ones are the National Waterway 1, from Prayagraj to Haldia on Ganga River, and from Sadia to Dhubri on Brahmaputra River in Assam, Waterway 2. Now 106 are new that are being formed. So total number of inland waterways in India will be 111. What is the name of the chairman? Amita Prasad. She is a female, Amita Prasad. So this was part 45 of the Railway Special Current Affairs in English language, and I hope you liked the video, enjoyed the video. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Do like, comment, share and subscribe, and don't forget to share the video with your friends. Thank you so much and see you in part 46.